Alright, welcome back to another RC Worst video. Today we're going to be doing a little response to a video that we posted recently. What to do when your septic alarm goes off. I kind of put that drawing together a little bit quickly initially when I first did the video, and I had made a mistake and just totally overlooked it once we were started filming. So I needed to address that in this video. So anyhow, when I had that picture of the septic tank up there, I talked about the normal liquid levels, and I talked about the alarm levels and the reserve capacity and so forth. But the reality is 95-98% of tanks, septic tanks, are not going to have a pump in them unless they're like a two compartment tank, which is actually really common. But usually you've got either a septic tank and then a pump tank, or you've got these two kind of crammed together in one tank with a concrete wall or barrier in between them. And really what that gets you is a little bit more of a flexible reserve capacity, because in that other video I mentioned that the reserve capacity is kind of the area in between the alarm and the inlet, and it fluctuates just a little bit and yada yada yada. But the point of it is the reserve capacity is actually the capacity that you have in the pump tank here, which is actually more important, because in the septic tank, usually the reason that you don't want to have a pump is because you've got these multiple layers that exist in a septic tank. And if you haven't watched our How a Septic Tank Works video, or if you haven't watched that video yet, How a Septic Tank Works, check it out. But anyways, so we've got the three sludge layer, or you've got the fats, greases, and oils, then you've got a sludge layer down here, and then you've got a relatively clean zone here. And what you're usually trying to do with the septic tank is you drop the material in and allow it to kind of separate. The oils and greases will float, the sludge and the heavy particles will sink, and then the kind of the clear stuff stays in the middle, the organic stuff. And then it gets passed through to this pump tank, and then that gets pumped to a drain field or wherever it goes from there, depending on your system. But the important thing about that is, since you have these separating layers, mixing them up can wreak a lot of havoc on whatever is downstream from your pump system, because getting the fats and oils in there can block things up. Getting the sludge in there can block things up. A lot of times you got a lot of inorganic material in that sludge layer that really isn't going to be able to decompose, at least in a normal time frame. So you want to just move primarily that clear liquid, and by constantly dropping water in this side and having a pump in here and your water levels bouncing all over the place, these layers tend to kind of merge together. So these will bleed in here, these will bleed in here, and it'll get more stirred up and churned up, and you'll be sending a worse end product out the discharge side. And that's why they don't do that. That's why you have a pump tank. That's why you have a two compartment septic tank, is because you're trying to not disturb that naturally occurring phenomenon, and you're trying to get that clear water out without that disruption. And then the whole goal, of course, is by having that second pump tank, you've got all this capacity here before you really start to have a problem, an alarm flow, pump on, or a pump on, pump off type of deal. And that's really all there is to that. I did mention that like 95% of the time, you're not pumping directly out of the septic tank. There are special screens and low volume rate discharge, so low flowing pumps that they do use in some of these situations, with like a, we call it a biotube filter, but those are only approved in certain areas. So at any rate, if you have any questions about this video, just a quick update for you, wanted to make sure that we addressed this little mishap here. Otherwise, don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out the other content on our channel. It's definitely a lot more thorough and complete than that last video or this video. So we'll catch you next time.